We are the KNR Rover team, a part of the Students Robotics Association at the Faculty of Power and Aeronautical Engineering at Warsaw University of Technology. Our story started in 2017 when the Rover team section of KNR was created. Its main goal was to develop a fully functional Martian rover. Since then, the project has gradually evolved, improving upon the design. We've built three generations of our rover so far. The current team includes around 35 members, organized into five technical divisions: mechanics, electronics, software, autonomy, and science. Over the years, we've taken part in several international student competitions. In 2024, we placed 14th in the finals of the European Rover Challenge in Krakow. We also qualified for the Anatolian Rover Challenge in 2023. Earlier, we participated in ERC from 2018 to 2024, as well as URC, first time in 2018 and 2019, and we are coming to URC again this year. In our team, we regularly organize meetings, training sessions, and drills for team members. This allows us to implement new and test existing procedures for operating our rover. We work from three project rooms located at our faculty, a space where we can build, test, and improve the rover step by step. Our rover utilizes a six-wheel design of a mobile platform. The mobile platform consists of a rocker buggy suspension attached to the hull, which contains all of the necessary components. The drive module includes BLDC motors and planetary gearboxes. The tires are made of polyurethane and coated with Uricoat to provide protection and improve traction. The mobile platform is primarily constructed out of aluminum and 3D printed components. A six-wheel rocker buggy suspension was chosen to provide the rover with the ability to navigate even the most difficult terrain. The BLDC motors with planetary gearboxes deliver sufficient power and torque to move the rover up the steep slopes. The tire's design offers effective shock absorption and necessary traction, but we are planning to make new tires using FDM technology. The modular design of the mobile platform allows for quick module changes to accommodate different tasks and make repairs or modifications much easier. The rover's electronics system is built on a modular microcontroller-based architecture featuring STM32 equipped PCBs, each dedicated to a specific subsystem. These boards are mounted on a custom rail system that enables parallel development and better communication. Power is managed by a battery management system monitoring voltage, temperature, and consumption across three parallel LiPo 4S batteries, delivering up to 5 kilowatts. A separate power management system handles regulated distribution to each module. Motor control boards integrate BLDC drivers, absolute encoders, CAN interfaces, and external controller support in a plug-and-play format, needing only power and CAN connections. A rear switch panel provides manual power control, illuminated status indicators, and a master switch for diagnostics and safe shutdown. To manage thermal load, a filtered cooling system supplies fresh air and maintains positive pressure, protecting components from dust and overheating. All PCBs include robust protection such as short circuit and overcurrent protection, overvoltage protection on signal lines and reverse polarity, and overvoltage protection on all power inputs. Mounted at the front of the rover is a high-performance 6-degree of freedom manipulator, engineered for precision and versatility. Constructed from laser-cut aluminum, the arm balances structural rigidity with a lightweight design. Its gripper, coated in polyurethane, ensures a secure hold on a wide range of objects, whether delicate or heavy. With a range of 1.2 meters, the arm is capable of lifting up to 16 kilograms near its base and 5 kilograms when fully extended. Each joint is driven by a high-efficiency Maxon brushless DC motor and absolute encoders with 1,000 pulses per revolution, provide reliable, calibration-free positioning. Control is handled via custom STM32 PCBs communicating over a robust CAN bus network. Thanks to its dual-mode architecture, the manipulator can be operated manually or fully autonomously through ROS2. Safety is built in with collision avoidance algorithms and state automata, coordinating complex task execution reliably and efficiently. Science payload consists of a laboratory module, which consists of an Archimedean screw drill used for collecting subsurface samples, and a revolving mechanism holding vials, which are used for field tests. A system of delivering reagents to the vials consists of a storage vessel and peristaltic pump. Analysis is done using a custom-built spectrometer and an array of diodes serving as a source of visible and UV light. Module also contains a system which seals vials for safety purposes and magnetic stirrer for properly mixing soil with reagents and buffer solutions. This system allows for soil analysis of various biosignatures using colorimetric and fluorescent methods, which are commonly used in field biology. Communication between the ground station and the rover is based on the 5 GHz routers that support Wi-Fi 6, enabling higher bandwidth and extended range. The ground station is powered by a router integrated with a high-gain directional antenna mounted on an extendable mast. The maximum height of the ground station antenna is 3 meters above the ground level. The rover is equipped with 2 omnidirectional antennas connected to a high-performance router. This network has replaced the previous 2.4 GHz setup. Field tests have shown that the new configuration provides a stable connection over a distance of 1000 meters in an open area and over 300 meters in environments with many obstacles. Low latency video for real-time navigation is provided by 6 5.8 GHz analog FPV cameras. The vision system is complemented by higher resolution digital cameras. One of them offers full 360-degree view. The rover can be controlled using a custom control panel enclosed in an aluminum transport case or a dedicated desktop application. Our control system runs on custom boards communicating over a canvas. They handle all movement, telemetry, and internal communication. We use a Z2 depth camera and a GNSS receiver with L-band RTK connected to an onboard computer powered by an NVIDIA GPU. While ROS2 forms our software's foundation, its heart is a visual SLAM, an accurate visual inertial odometry. It builds a live map of the environment, while NAV2 handles both local and global navigation. We focus heavily on a computer vision. The system detects and localizes arrow markers and ground objects, even in difficult lighting conditions. Equipped with a laboratory module integrating instruments such as a spectrometer and a coring drill, the rover is capable of sample acquisition and analysis. The rover can be configured with a robotic manipulator, which combined with its all-wheel drive system enables the handling and towing of high-mass payloads while maintaining fine motion control for precise manipulation of smaller components. An onboard algorithm facilitates detection and interaction with tactile interfaces, such as keypads, optimizing data input procedures. A custom autonomy module enables the rover to perform fully autonomous navigation to predefined waypoints. During traversal, the rover dynamically plans its path and performs real-time obstacle avoidance using onboard perception and decision-making systems. The rover supports an ARC-RCSP module and can be stopped through the protocol. We are continuously modernizing our whole O60 rover, driven by our ambition for improvement and success. The Anatolian Rover Challenge fuels our passion, and we can't wait to compete. Thanks for tuning in. See you at ARC.